Arkansas Republican Senator Tom Cotton joins us now. Senator, great to see you as always. So they locked down 20 million people in three provinces, but that's the bad news. Good news is they're giving social media to athletes. And who said China was authoritarian?
Yeah, Trace, I'm sure that athletes from the United States and Western nations will post freely about China's crackdown and imposition of martial law in Hong Kong, about its threatening of Taiwan, about its genocide against racial and religious and ethnic minorities in Northwest China. I'm sure that all those posts are going to go out without any censorship at all by the Chinese Communist Party or without any threat of reprisal. This is a joke. This is simply designed to try to cover up and to protect its reputation when so many Western companies and Western countries are finally beginning to acknowledge what's going on in China, even if they're not willing to do what we should, which is boycott the Olympics.
Yeah, former Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said this about this whole social media access thing. Watch.
Those people in the Chinese Communist Party know those athletes are coming. They're going to monitor every single thing they say, every single thing they do. They will keep that in the hands, the clutches of the Chinese Communist Party forever. There are so many great places you could host an Olympics, but not in this tyrannical regime that is designed to do so many bad things to so many people, and who doesn't care about life in the way that we do. It doesn't respect rights.
Yeah, so somebody's watching you is what the theme is here. Your thoughts?
Yeah, Trace, last summer I asked the Biden administration about their plan to protect our athletes, to protect them from around-the-clock surveillance, protect them from DNA harvesting, to protect them from simple kidnapping or hostage-taking or unlawful arrest. They gave no answer. That's why a couple months ago I called for a boycott of these Olympics, because we cannot guarantee the safety of our athletes. Do we really trust the Chinese Communist Party won't arbitrarily arrest and detain American athletes or coaches or trainers or other staff because they did try to post something about Taiwan or about Hong Kong, or they did try to fly a flag outside the Olympic Village or make a gesture on the medal stand? I certainly don't, and I'm disappointed the Biden administration does. Look, with COVID rampaging across China, there's every reason to postpone these Olympics, just like the the games in Tokyo in 2020 were postponed. And move them somewhere else in the near future.
We focus a lot on the athletes, but, you know, the surveillance could extend to the visitors, the people who are going there to watch the Olympics. Fair?
That is fair. No American, whether they're on the Olympic delegation itself, a member of the media, someone who's in the country and wants to watch the games, is safe from this kind of surveillance or this kind of arbitrary arrest and detention by the Chinese Communist Party.
I'm wondering, Senator, if you think that it's odd that you have some of these companies, these global corporations, that literally, we talked about this earlier, that literally are celebrating the Beijing Olympics. American companies, same companies like Coca-Cola that said, you know, the All-Star Game needs to be out of Georgia.
Yeah, I don't find it odd. I find it revolting, Trace, that a company like Coca-Cola, which boycotts its own state for passing a democratic law that would make it easier to vote and hard to cheat, is at the same time celebrating the Chinese Communist Party throwing their genocide Olympics. No company should be celebrating these games, but all of these companies are obsessed with getting cheap stuff out of their Chinese plants or getting access into the Chinese market or both. It's shameful that they're willing to put profits above patriotism and above freedom.
But I'm curious, sir, what kind of pushback or response have you gotten when you say, and you've advocated this several times, to boycott these Olympics, to get out of these Olympics and go elsewhere?
Well, obviously, the athletes don't want to miss their shot at Olympic gold. I don't want them to miss it either. I put the blame, though, on the Biden administration, secondarily on the International Olympic Committee for citing these games in China in the first place. The fact that now China poses such a grave COVID risk as well, again, gives good reason to postpone these Olympics and to place them elsewhere in the civilized world. So these athletes will have a chance later this summer when it's winter in the Southern Hemisphere, or next winter if you go somewhere, say, in Europe to conduct these games. It happened with the Summer Games in 2020, which are much larger and much more complex. If it can happen with the Summer Games, it can happen with the Winter Games.
Yeah. Senator Cotton, good to see you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Trace.